Smart locks. Smart locks come in a variety of brands and a variety of styles.
Okay.
From a style standpoint, you've got different looks and feels. You've got different finishes, like silver or like a darker bronze mm-hmm. or brass or things like that. You've also got different styles in terms of deadbolts versus handle locks.
That's what I was going to ask. This one doesn't have a handle.
Yeah, so this is meant to replace a deadbolt.
Okay.
And what you do is you would get this piece would go on the inside of your home, and it's got the motor mm-hmm. inside it and the batteries. And then this front piece goes on the outside of the home. And it is weather resistant. You know, it's heat resistant, cold resistant, things like that.
Okay.
So they're tested to be able to work in all conditions. But the thing that's unique about these is unlike a regular deadbolt that just has a keyhole, these actually have a keypad as well. And so you can do everything code-based. The same code system you use on the panel, you use on the lock.
That's nice.
Yeah, so you can literally set up codes for everyone you know
mm-hmm.
Who is going to have access to your home. You know, you've got your mom, your dad, your brother, sister, dog walker, babysitter. Yeah, anybody who's going to come and go inside your home, instead of giving them a key that they potentially lose and then you got to rekey your locks, you give them a code. And that code is also disposable. So if you say that boyfriend that you gave a code to, you don't want him to have access to your home anymore,
uh-huh.
you simply turn off his code and now he can't get in anymore.
Nice.
So nice way of doing access control. And a level of security for your door. The other thing that's nice is for those people that like to exercise or run or things like that, you don't have to worry about carrying keys with you because now you literally go inside the house with a code. Okay? So they're smart. They are connected to the panel over Z-Wave technology. And the range on those is generally about 15 feet, sometimes 30 feet, depending on the panel, depending on the system. But you want to be careful that if the lock can't reach the panel, that you're adding things like maybe a lamp module or a smart light bulb in between to help bridge the gap between the panel if needs be.
Make sure it's working.
Yep. You know, another good thing about a smart lock is because it's part of a whole ecosystem,
mm-hmm.
you can do things that automate the lock. So, for example, with the panel and its Bluetooth touchless disarming, you could say, when panel disarmed, by my phone, when my phone gets in range,
yeah.
also unlock the front door. So at our house, cool. for example, when my wife gets home, she grabs the baby, she grabs her purse, grabs any bags she might have, she walks up towards the house, and as she's walking towards the house, her phone authenticates with the panel
mm-hmm.
and says, disarm system, and then we have a rule that says, when panel disarmed, unlock the front door. So she literally, by the time she gets to the front door is unlocked, and she just goes inside. So it's a real nice way of automating your home to make it easier for you to come home. Now, there's another thing that happens when you've got that kind of automation is in order to get that lock to unlock itself,
mm-hmm.
the panel has to be armed. The panel has to be armed away, which means
okay.
that she is now remembering to when she leaves to arm the system in away mode so that she
works.
Can have the automation when she gets back. It's increasing the usage of the customer, so now they're using the system more often because they want to use it less as they come home. They want to not have to type
in
a code.
They want everything to do it for them.
Yeah, it makes it a lot easier. They even come without a key. So this one has a key
oh,
in it,
really?
But there's some that have no key on it. It's just a keypad, which makes it a lot smaller. I actually have that one on my front porch, and I never have to worry about a key because I don't even own a key. It doesn't even have a key. So it makes things a lot easier for us because when people come over, in fact, great example of this, our parents came over this weekend to come visit the grandkids.
Mm-hmm.
And when they arrived, you know, they tried to type their code in. And because we'd replaced the lock, the new lock didn't have their code. They weren't allowed to come in. And so I had to go on myalarm.com account and actually activate
their
user so that they
okay.
could do it. But it was nice to be able to know that lock is controlling who accesses my home. There's also a level of voice control that occurs here too. So you could say things like, Alexa, lock the front door, and the front door will lock. If you want to unlock it, you can do that with a code. You'd set up a code in there and you'd say, Alexa, unlock the front door. And she'd say, what's your passcode? And you'd say 1234 or whatever your code
Perfect.
Was.
So you'd have to know the password in order to
Yeah.
unlock it.
So it keeps it safe, keeps people that, you know, are going to yell through your windows or your doors.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Alexa, unlock the front door. She's going to say, sorry, you need a code to do that.
Okay.
But locking, anybody can lock the door. Anybody can make the home safe. With a simple voice command. So a lot of different ways to do it. Of course, you can use your mobile app to lock the door. You can create scenes within your mobile app that says, you know, when I come home, automatically lock the door, or when I arm my security system, lock the door, things like that. So All that automation starts with having a wireless radio in the lock that communicates with the panel, and then all of the automation occurs in the cloud.
Perfect.
So really powerful solution, definitely one you should look at.
Okay.